Here she goes again. Jinny crazy talking again. She crazy talking again. The thing she says in these B-side verses every time, like, what? 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 Oh, the bad. Okay, Dita, what? Welcome to my palace. Champagne in your chalice. Even I'm not swinging forward to me. Tell the little boy so we can to deep. Rolling around the world. Hello, Lockies. What is going on? My name is the Newbie Warrior, and welcome back to my K-pop reaction channel. And finally, we're getting to Ola. The reason this was delayed quite a bit is I didn't realize that their music was now distributed by UMG, which I should have, because Vivo is UMG's subsidiary. But basically, I spent 2 hours trying to re-edit and upload my MV reaction for DOOMCHITA, which, by the way, is incredible. Not my reaction, the song. The song in the video, not my reaction. My reaction's fine. But the video and the song, incredible. I think this is the first time that a title track has made me go, wait, is this the best one? Because God, that boom was pretty locked in, you know? It's like, there wasn't, you know, there was no way I thought God, that boom was gonna get topped. I don't know. Ola's pretty, Ola. DOOMCHITA's pretty good, so I don't know yet. But yeah, so I know in the future it won't be an issue. I'll just start off with my first upload by putting, you know, an image overlay over the video, and that should be fine. And, so yeah, going forward it shouldn't be a problem, other than the secret number reactions are going to be heavily edited now for music videos. Sorry. It's the label doing that. Well, actually, it's the label's distribution partner. Anyway, point being, I'm really excited. If you do want to see my uncut reaction, the full reaction, no screen filter, no weirdness, no clips cut out, no audio modification, that's on my Patreon under the $1 tier. And anyone subscribing to my Patreon, like I said, $1 a month, you get access to all my blocked reactions as well as live stages. So maybe enjoy some other stuff while you're there. I'm super excited. Traditionally, I like the B-side even more than the title track for Secret Number. That is true in every case. That is true in every case so far in their discography. So far, Who Dis is great, Holiday's better, Got That Boom, amazing, my favorite of their title tracks before this, Privacy is still better somehow, Fire Saturday, I liked but wasn't in love with, but Dangerous in Love is incredible, it's incredible. Dangerous in Love is amazing. And now we're in an interesting spot because DOOMCHITA is incredible. As a matter of fact, I haven't even opened it up on Spotify yet. It's incredible. I'm considering putting it in my Song of the Year contenders. I think it might be up there. I'm going to give it a few more listens before I decide, but it could be. So it feels like there's no way Ola should be better than this. Like, it feels like there's no way Ola should be better than this. But every single other Secret Number B-side I like more than the title. So let's find out if that's also true. If you do want to see my reactions to, hopefully the performance video for this that Vine's making, right, guys, Vine? Dance practice, lyric video for DOOMCHITA. We're going to keep the Secret Number reactions rolling, so yeah, subscribe maybe. Let's go. Hola. So we have some like melodic keys and the Spanish guitar. Ooh, the breathiness. When I think of you, I become hot. When I look at you, I become happy. The breathiness. This is like a wistful romance so far. Wow. Ooh, the harmony. Ooh. okay. What does a drop like this sound like? Me? You want me? Hold on. I hate to interrupt drop. No, I don't. You guys know. I pause all the time. But this... That's a really interesting sound to have in a build. Right? It's not here yet. Oh. Okay. Little bit of a funky brass in. This is really pretty. This is really pretty. Man, that guitar grooves. It's so good, actually. It's like shockingly groovy for how pretty it is. The bass is thumping, but it's the vocals are all pretty and kind of like airy and. Here she goes again. Jinny crazy talking again. She crazy talking again. The thing she says in these B-side verses every time, like, what? 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 Oh, the bad. Okay, Dita, what? What? Again with the breathy trail offs. I don't give up. Da, 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 da. It's so like, whoa. It really like puts you on edge, kinda. We have these vocal harmony builds again. I can't get over how cool that build is. I'm sorry, I can't get over how cool the build is. This is really nice. Oh, dude, Minji's voice is so pretty. It's so pretty. Okay. Bridge. I'm sorry, these trail offs. These, like, all of these phrases are so pretty. They're so pretty. That's a really addictive hook. Okay, I'm sorry. Both the title track and Hola have these really cool, like, ad-lib is the wrong word. They're almost like, they're produced so much, they're almost like tags, like vocal tags, where it's basically just like, a little bit of a vocal that's been like super synthesized and played with, and then it's basically being played as a synth. And there's really cool, it's done really well in this and their last song, both. Like, I'm pretty sure that, I'm pretty sure that's starting as a vocal. Never. I would never let you go. Oh, that's really good. That's really good. But do you know what? I think for the first time ever, I like it less than the title track, which is not even a slight to Ola. Ola's great. It's really pretty. It's just DOOMCHITA just absolutely bangs. But this is so pretty. The guitar, the like light wispy trail offs on all the vocals. The snap is also a really light form of percussion. The breathy, like, whispered vocals and, like, the one spoken vocal from Dita. Like, they're really cool moments. Like, little production things, little delivery things. And then it's just a really pretty Latin guitar bass. Kind of like I said, like a wistful love song, right? It's this, I love that person so much, but it's like, it's almost, it's like, it's beautiful, but it's also, like, tragic. It's, you know, it's very melodramatic, right? Even with the lyrics in this starting bit, save me, help me, I fell directly. Like, these are, it's so, I'm trying to think of the word. It's so, I keep coming back to, like, wistful, which is not correct. Not necessarily what I'm trying to get, but it's really interesting. The song is very longing. It's a very kind of longing portrayal of love. It's like a beautiful, tragic love. And, like, clearly, whoever they're singing about, like, there's that, like, whoa, I want you. But, like, it's kind of destroying me that I want you. And, like, maybe, I can't tell, maybe we can't have a thing. Maybe because it destroys me. Maybe for another reason. Maybe it's already broke up. Maybe something else. Maybe they're just not interested, whatever, but it's this really interesting kind of, like you're throwing yourself desperately at somebody, like a, please just listen to me, I need this. Hello. Hello, look at me, hello. I need you. It's a really, really kind of cool, but it's not forceful. It's desperate. It's a really cool sound and a really cool kind of context, I think, with the lyrics and the delivery. And then the lines are all just so pretty. The instrumental's gorgeous. Not too repetitive. Really cool ad-libs. Really cool harmonies. Really good use of processing. Yeah, this is like, it's incredible. It's just, man, I actually think for the first time, I like a title track more for Secret. DOOMCHITA's. Unreal, it's unreal, and I'm so sad I had to butcher my reaction. I had to butcher my reaction to it to get it on YouTube, but absolutely incredible. Thank you so much for watching. I love this song, man. I really do. Secret Number B-sides continue 100%. I'm obsessed with them. Every single B-side, like, they have so much good music. Such a high percentage of good music. Now, if we could just get a mini album. If we could just get a mini album, Vine. Please, I beg. Please. Anyway. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Lockies, for all the love you guys showed in the channel. Especially those of you who liked and left comments on all three uploads when I was trying to react to the music video. You know who you are. I love and appreciate you especially. Especially people who are like making the same joke or comment. And I could tell it's like slightly changed because the video obviously was taken offline, so they couldn't like copy paste it even. So thank you to anyone who like re-liked the video, reposted your comments, rewatched. I appreciate it so much. In the future, I won't have to do re-uploads and everything with Secret Number. I'll just know that I need to put a filter over the video and first upload should be fine. I'm thinking so. Anyway, like I said, subscribe. We are going to continue rolling with the Secret Number hype. We're going to be reacting to the to probably some stuff from the showcase. I'm assuming they perform both songs, so I'm not sure if I'm going to do one video with both the songs in it or if I'm going to do two separate videos. You guys can let me know in the comments if there was a really good source. I saw Tong Tong posted it. That might be what I go with, but if there's a better upload of it, or you guys saw a better upload of their showcase performances, let me know. I can use that. Thank you guys so much. More Secret Number content coming soon, and please remember to stay nerdy. Thank you so much to everyone who's chosen to support me this month on Patreon, with special appreciation going to Wookbook, Daniel Reigns, Muse Ribbons, Nex, Lucky7Gen, 42 Ariadna, Atsushi Ray H, Dwight, Mushroomy, Jalen Raybon, Louise Zako, Q, Stephen Wong, and Jyoti Sharma.